Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and everybody knows I've been working on the 30-day query folding challenge from Alex Powers, and people ask me, are you making any progress? Where are you with the 30-day challenge? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. 30-day query folding challenge. I gotta admit, moving kind of slow. I was actually working on one last night, and then I hit this one, and I got really excited about it because while the first few that I worked on kind of focused on the data, this one focuses on the schema. It wants me to remove some columns, and you know how Adam and I always talk about removing unnecessary columns from your model that you don't need, right? And that's what this folding challenge is focused on. So you guys know what I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So here's the challenge. I need this database, Scott. I need this entity or table, got it. And here's the instructions. Dynamically select all the columns that do not contain the text key. So over here in Power Query, I have my query. And what I want to do is remove all these columns that contain a key. So what I did was I actually did a remove so I can see what Power Query would do. And it just needs this list of column names. I'm like, I could do that. I actually made a copy of it and then I got rid of it just for reference. And then what I did was made me a little playground just so I can do some testing. Then go into my advanced editor. We're gonna call this dim employee and we click done. And now what I wanna do is see if I can get a list of these columns. So I went right here and I'm gonna rename this to get column names. And so from the source, I type table, there's a function called column names. And so it returns a list of them. It's beautiful. This is where I ran into the challenge. It was like, how do I find all the columns that contain the word key? Because I need to remove them. I need to create a list so I can add it to that remove columns function. So create another function and I'm gonna rename this one and call this one get key columns. And then over here, this is a list. So I know there's a group of functions for lists and there was this one that popped up called find text. So that's the one I went with. And the second input is text. And I said, it's no way it's gonna be this easy. Boom, all the columns that contain a key. The next thing I did was absolutely unnecessary, but in my T-SQL and my DAX mind, it made sense. You remember the remove column functions accepted a comma delimit list of column names. So what I did was, don't laugh, I renamed this one to get key column list. It's gonna be so funny. And I did a text.combine and I put a comma and I made a comma delimited list. And then finally, I renamed this my result and I did this table.remove columns, the source, because I want to remove the column from my source. And then I passed in my get key column list. I actually wrapped it in the brackets. What do you think happened? I got an error. It said, hey, you can't do that. This thing expects a list. So if you look at the function, if we go right here, it says, I need some columns. And I already had those columns right here in get key columns. So I'm gonna do get key columns. That's the ones I wanna remove. Watch this, boom, it did it. I was so excited. So then I went into my advanced editor. I deleted this because I don't need that anymore. And all I needed are these three guys right here. So we're gonna do that, we're gonna hit done. And we go back to dim employee. Then we're gonna go to the advanced editor. And then right here, paste this in. And everywhere I see source, I'm gonna replace it with this because this returns the rows in the table. Right here, and then copy result and paste that right there. So basically what I'm doing is connecting to the server, get the database, get the table, and then I'm getting a list of all the column names. I'm finding the ones that contain key, and then I'm removing them from my tables. Click done, boom, it worked. The most hilarious part of all this is I went through all of that and not at one point did I check to see if each one of my steps were folding. So I had to cross my fingers and let's check. So right here, right click, view native query, boom, it's folding. Now, let's see what Alex did. So I already brought it up. I'm gonna copy this and then I'm gonna head back to Power Query, create a new blank query, and we're gonna paste Alex's in and I need to make a few changes. And now we're gonna click done. Wait for it, same thing. The key columns are gone. Let's right click right here, view native query, it folds. Let's take a peek and see what Alex did. So we're gonna go to advanced editor. First couple of steps are the same, but then he did list.select columns. Ah, and then he used the each to say select the ones that does not contain the key, and then he removed the other columns. So he did the opposite of what I did, and then he selected the columns that did not contain the key. Pretty interesting. But it got me to thinking, what if I wanted to do this for multiple queries in my model? I decided I'm going to take mine and make a function out of it. So new blank query, let's go into the advanced editor, grab it, already typed it, and let's paste it. I'm saying here's the input, use the input, whatever you input it as, I'm going to input my table and use it as a source and walk through the exact same steps. Done. And then I'm going to head over here. Instead of having all these five steps, I have this reusable function. Let's just rename this FX remove key columns. And then over here in my advanced editor, get rid of these two right here. And then let's get rid of all this. I'm going to need this because I'm going to pass this in as my input and replace this function with my function. Let's see if it works. Done. And now let's see if it folds. Boom, it still folds. I'm excited, it works. Now I have this reusable function. I have multiple tables and I don't remove key columns. I can do it. All right, what do you think? Where are you in the folding challenge? I love to know. Are you struggling? Are you making it through? If you have any questions, comments, you know what to do. Let's continue the conversation. Where? In the comments below. Your first time visiting the GuideIncube channel, hit that subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.